Hello everyone. So today we would be discussing the daily MCQs of June 27, 2018. And these MCQs are prepared keeping in mind their importance in exams like RBI Phase 1, the SBI PO exam, the IBPS PO exam. Although there are no current affairs in the prelims of SBI PO, but in the second tier or the second phase of SBI PO, the current affairs are asked. The current affairs are asked again in the SSC CGL examination as well. So if you wish to read the daily current affairs, you can visit the website www.anujjindal.in, and along with this you can attempt the free quiz, the free daily current affairs quiz, so that you can keep a check on your knowledge. Let's start with the first question. The first question says China will reduce tariffs on soybean imported from 5 countries from dash to dash. So there was some amount of tariff imposed on the soybean which is being imported in China from 5 countries. Now it has been reduced from 3% to 0%. So earlier the tariff was 3% and now it has been reduced to 0%. So there are no tariffs on soybean on import from these 5 countries. Now, which are the 5 countries which are exempted from the tariffs? The first is India. Next is South Korea, Bangladesh, Laos, Sri Lanka. So these are the 5 countries which are being exempted from any tariffs on soybean. So earlier it was 3%, now it's 0%. If we talk about India, then India is the world's 6th biggest producer. And what about China? So China is the biggest and the largest consumer of soybean. So China is importing approximately 90% of its needs. And India being the 6th producer is among the biggest contributors of soybean to China. Next question is, what is Mumbai's rank as per the 2018 cost of living survey? So this cost of living survey is being conducted by the firm Mercer, and Mumbai has ranked 55, which is highest in India. Now, how does this survey calculate the cost of living? So this survey takes into consideration the cost of living for the expatriates. So not all the people are considered, only the expatriates are considered. Now, who all are these expatriates? So these expatriates are people who temporarily or permanently residing in a country other than their native country. So if a person out of employment needs or out of any need move out of its native country, so to some another country, then he is being called as the expatriate. If we look at these stats, then Mumbai has ranked the costliest, that is the highest in India, Delhi at 103, Chennai has ranked 144 above Bengaluru and Kolkata. The most expensive city in the world is Hong Kong, the next being Tokyo. If we compare Mumbai with the other cities like Melbourne or Frankfurt, then Mumbai is much costlier than these two cities as well, Melbourne and Frankfurt. So Melbourne has been ranked at 58 and Frankfurt at 68. Next question is, which government has announced a new policy under which medical students who quit their course midway will have to shell out some amount as compensation? So Haryana government has come up with this policy or has announced this policy under which if a medical student quit their course midway or if they quit in the middle of the course, then they would have to shell out up to ₹7.5 lakh. So if a PG new student, PG means the postgraduate students who quit before completion of their course will be barred from seeking admissions to another institute for 3 years. Apart from paying the compensation, they will be barred from taking admissions as well next 3 years. If we talk about the undergraduate students who are pursuing MBBS or BDS. BDS is the dental studies. Then undergraduate students have to pay rupees 5 lakh if they quit the course in the midway. And this practice of executing the bond has been made compulsory for the first time in the state. So this is the first time Haryana has imposed this bond policy, because in the recent past, many of the medical institutes had to struggle with the vacancy. So people or the students leave in the middle of the course and the medical institutes have to struggle with vacant seats. So therefore, this policy has been imposed by Haryana government. Who is the chairman of the Kaveri Water Regulation Committee? So as per the provisions of the Kaveri Management Scheme, which are being laid down by the Supreme Court of India, the central government has come up with this Kaveri Water Regulation Committee, and S. Mehmood Hussain, so the option B, S. Mehmood Hussain has been made its chairman. And what is the purpose of this committee? So this committee will assess the Kaveri Management Authority to implement the Kaveri Water Disputes Tribunal. So there is a continuous dispute going on between Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. So to settle the dispute or give a resolution for this dispute, this Kaveri Water Regulation Committee has been established. Next question is, which ministry has recently launched its report titled Women in Prison? If you wish to guess the answer, then please pause the video and guess the answer. The answer for this question is Ministry of Women and Child Development. So the Ministry of Women and Child Development has come up with this report titled Women in Prisons so that they could bring an understanding or build an understanding of the various challenges faced by the women prisoners and to bring out the resolutions for the same. So this report is a comprehensive list of 134 recommendations. And how are these recommendations aligned? So the report has recommended to amend the National Model Prison Manual 2016 so that they could bring it in line with the international norms and the standards. Therefore, the Ministry of Women and Child Development has launched this or come up with this Women in Prisons report. If you look at the stats or the most recent data as of 2015, then there are approximately 419,623 prisoners. And out of which 17,834, which is approximately 4.3%, are women prisoners. If you look into detail, then majority of the female inmates or majority of the women female prisoners are in the age group 30 to 50, which accounts for 50.5% of the total women prisoners, and approximately 31.3% of the 18 to 30 years of the age group. Another question is, Pani Bachao Paise Kamao is the campaign launched by which state or the union territory? So this scheme has been launched by Punjab so that they could encourage farmers and to keep a check on the depletion of the underground water. How will this scheme benefit the farmers, or how will the farmers get the monetary benefits out of this scheme? So farmers will be provided with the monetary benefits for less use of tube well. So if they would be using less of the tube well, then they would be able to earn the monetary benefits out of this scheme. And this scheme has been launched in just two clusters right now. The first one being the Bambiwal and another being Nawazipur. This is an interesting question. So the Godikan Panchayat has passed a resolution to marry girls only to families that have a toilet in their house. Where is Godikan located? So Godikan is a small village in the Sirsa district of Haryana. So the answer for this question is Haryana, because Godikan is located in the Sirsa district. And this is the first time और दिस इज द फर्स्ट पंचायत इन इंडिया विच हैज कम अप विद दिस रेजोल्यूशन एज दे आर इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम द अक्षय कुमार मूवी ऑफ टॉयलेट एक प्रेम कथा एंड दे हैव मेड अ रेजोल्यूशन टू मैरी गर्ल्स ओनली टू द फैमिलीज दैट हैव अ टॉयलेट इन देयर हाउस. The next question is, name of the taxi service app launched by Goa. So, Goa has come up with the, or the tourism department of Goa has come up with this app, Goa Miles, which is an app-based taxi service. And currently, the tourist taxi operators run the business individually in Goa. So, Goa government or the Goa tourist department has come up with this scheme so that they could enable the ease of travel for tourists and make it digitally enabled for the drivers as well. Currently, this app is in the final stage of testing and we will be launched by July 2018. Who has been appointed as the first visually impaired judge of Pakistan? So this is the first time Pakistan appointed a first visually impaired or a blind judge as a civil judge, and Yusuf Saleem has been appointed as the first visually impaired judge of Pakistan. If we talk about India, then Brahmanand Sharma of Rajasthan has become the first Rajasthan visually impaired judge. Last question for today is, June 27th is observed as, so for the first time in 2017, MSME Day, which is Micro, Small and Medium Sized Enterprises Day, was observed. And this day was observed to raise public awareness of the contribution to the sustainable development given by these micro, small and medium sized enterprises. If you look at this picture, then this picture is a beautiful description of how micro, small and medium sized enterprises are contributing or bringing the big impact in the society. If we talk about the rest of the days, then World Ocean Day is observed each year on 8th June. Nelson Mandela International Day is observed on 18th July. Micro, Small and Medium, as we discussed, June 27th. World Autism Awareness Day is observed on April 2nd. And the World Poetry Day on March 21st. If you make the habit of reading the daily current affairs, or if you read the current affairs on daily basis, then it would be easier for you to remember these days and the current affairs, and you just need to revise these current affairs at the time of your examination. This is all for today. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal and come up with the feedback in the comment section below so that we can improve on our videos or the content. Join our YouTube community and get the latest updates and announcements. We have Success RBI and Success SBI group on Facebook and Telegram, which you can join, and you can join us on WhatsApp and Twitter as well. Please download the Infinity app from the Google Play Store and it would be easier for you to access the material on your mobile phones. Thank you.